When we reached in Liberia, we found no step on the ground apart from the MSF who had constructed an ITU in Elwatu. So patients were flooding like water on streets, in their homes, in the community, everywhere. There was no help at all. So we started by constructing an emergency isolation unit of about 100 beds and started immediately. But before even 2 days ended, that isolation unit was full up with floor cases and all the beds were full. It wasn't enough at all. So we stayed there for 1 month. Then after 1 month, we handed over that one to the Liberians whom we had trained, then shifted to an island clinic where we again set another clinic of about 100 beds. But still that one, before the week ended, it was also full up with floor cases, and other cases you would find on the veranda, in the compound like that. The whole unit was like this. And even where to step was a bit difficult because they were just packed like there is a dead body there, there is an unconscious person, there is a mother with babies, they are touching you, they are following you, they are crying. So that was the situation. So handling them also became difficult. But the health workers from Liberia, they kept on striking. They could do from time to time lay their tools down, and whenever they could do that, we are the ones to suffer because for us we are on at the station full time. So whenever they could give up, we had to do what? To continue with the work, whereby the number was too many for us to handle. You can't manage the community minus the government. Most of them have got their beliefs. For example, like the Muslims believe on bathing dead bodies. Now to stop them, that was a problem. That's why we left a big number in the ETU, the 15 cases from the same village. They had contracted the disease from a sheikh who had died, and they smeared themselves with that water for blessings. That's what they told us when we admitted them. They said for them, after burying the sheikh, they smeared with the water which they used to bathe their dead bodies. That water contains blessings. That's how they contracted Ebola. Others, like the pastors, continued to pray over patients. Somebody with Ebola runs out of the ETU, that the nurses, the doctors are deceiving, there is Ebola, there is no Ebola, it is a witch. So they could run to their community, to those pastors. Then for them, they end up touching on them, playing over them. The end results, Ebola. So that's what we went through. We can succeed in the management of the Ebola when you are working together as a team. And when there is manpower, finance, and the most thing, the government must be involved.